laugh, play, and have fun. Most people take life far too seriously. You and I are not going to get out of this life alive, so why not enjoy the gift of life today as if it were your last? One day you will be right. One of the key traits of truly happy people is their ability to have fun. Laughter is medicine for the soul. It helps you reduce the negative impact of the stressors in your life, as well as see the problems you may be facing for what they really are: temporary teachers on the path of life. Why does having fun mean to you? When was the last time you played hooky and just spent the day doing what you wanted to do, not what you had to do? I have a great many heroes. As I was recently considering their impact on my life, I realized that most of them made me laugh. There was Will Rogers and Mark Twain, George Burns and Red Skelton. There was Groucho Marx and Steve Allen. How about Ernie Kovacs? I could go on, but the point is, we all need to laugh more, smile more, enjoy the gift of life more. Few people will say on their deathbed that they should have worked harder, attended more meetings, made more money, or saved more money. Few people will say they should have learned more, thought more, become more, or seen more. I will bet that many, however, will say they should have laughed and smiled more. Have some fun today. Doesn't matter how you define fun. Just have some. You will be better able to face the struggles, problems, challenges, and trials that life throws your way. While you are at it, why not brighten someone else's day as well? Do something to bring a smile to their face or help them have fun. Have some fun. You both will feel better. After returning from a week's speaking tour in Buenos Aires, one thing I noticed about many of the people I met was how open they smiled and how happy they were. It was a wonderful trip and I can't wait to return. I like being around happy people. All work and no play is not healthy nor in your long-term best interest. We are all busy chasing success, lifestyles, stuff, achievements, fame, power, recognition, and a variety of temporary and often useless goals. Have no doubt, I believe in work. I believe in paying the price of success. However, many people pay too high a price. They pay with their relationships and open their life. Fun and laughter have value in creating a peaceful and harmonious lifestyle. I have often heard business owners, managers, and executives brag about not having taken a vacation in 5 years. I believe if this is so, you have brain damage. We all need to recharge our batteries, and one way to accomplish that is to create diversions in your life or non-work-related activities. I have also been hearing the following a lot lately. This business, job, or career just isn't as much as fun as it used to be. Fun is not in a job any more than passion is in a relationship. Fun and passion are in people. If your job isn't fun anymore, stop looking at the job. Look in the mirror, or better still, look deep inside your attitudes, values, and expectation, or the cause of this malaise. You can put fun or passion back into a job, and you can put passion or fun back into a relationship. You can put passion or fun back into a relationship. You get this back into yourself. So what are you doing for fun these days? What are you doing to recharge your mental and physical batteries? What are you doing to put passion back into yourself? What are you doing to live with balance and harmony? What are you doing to enjoy your life other than work? What are you doing to find inner peace? What are you doing to enjoy the gift of each day you are given? Having fun yet? Jobs, careers, running a business, parenting, and studying, for instance, are not fun. They are work. Fun as a concept is not part of any job or career. I know because I have heard some people in the same career for the same organization say how much fun it was, while others in the same career in the same organization complain about how little fun it was. If your job, for example, is not as much as fun as it used to be, don't look at how the job has changed, but how you have changed. I love to speak and write, and I will continue to do both as long as my health permits. Retirement is not in my vocabulary. I'm not being critical of people who retire, but think about it. If you love what you did, why would you want to stop doing it? The reason most people retire is they can finally do what they want to do with their life. Personally, I find this quite depressing, that we spend 40 plus years doing what we hate or what to do, and we can spend 5, 10, or if we are lucky, 15 or more years doing what we want or like to do. I am not suggesting that you shouldn't retire. I am only asking you to consider that if you must spend more than half of your life working, why not spend it doing what you love or at least like? Lots of my speaker friends have lately been talking a lot about slowing down and even retiring, but in their next breath, they say how much they love what they are doing. Does it puzzle you as much as it does me? I am confused here, Fox. How can you get fun back into your attitudes, feelings, beliefs, philosophy, or behavior? It takes work. Nothing in life that is worthwhile is easy, but it can be done. Why not try the following? See if you can smile at everyone you meet or see this week, whether you know them or not. Trust me, it isn't as easy to do as it is easy for me to suggest try it, but it will be worthwhile. Little pleasures. Life is all about gratitude for the little things, the things we often take for granted. Oh yes, there are big achievements, big plans, big toys, big stuff, big problems, and big failures. But this past leaving broken or challenged spirits or hearts in their wake. It's the little things that really count. Life accumulates moment by moment, day by day. In each moment, there is the potential for new awareness, new growth, miracles, new thoughts, and new sights, sounds, and tastes. Each of these often comes disguised in the little events that surround us daily. A smile from a stranger, a sincere hug from a friend, an unexpected call that says, "You matter and I care." A rainbow, a double rainbow. I saw my first one while speaking in Ireland, and there are others, such as when all the traffic lights green turn as you pass through town, when your plane is on time, and when the rain stops just as you leave the protection of your car, you forgot your umbrella, when you find something important you thought was lost. There are millions of other little pleasures each day if you only would take the time to notice. A friend shared this concept of little pleasures with me a few years ago, so I'm passing it along to you, thinking it might do for you what it did for me. Keep me focused on what matters in life, and not what doesn't. Little pleasures are all of those seemingly unimportant signals, events, situations, signs, people, and circumstances that make you smile. It works like this. Find something positive you want to focus on today. For example, today while sitting in your car waiting for the light to turn green, you will notice everyone who looks at you. When they return your glance, you will give them a warm, broad smile. Today, every time the sun passes behind a cloud, you will think of how much in life you are grateful for. You will notice the kind words that others say about you, and you will feel warm and peaceful inside. Well, I have given you the philosophy and a few ideas. Why not begin every day this week with a little pleasure? Do it big, do it right, give it class. Life without laughter is a dray blank. Dreams are the touchstones of our characters. From the book of Tim Kanar, Life is Short. Live, laugh, and love while you can.
just because of you, boy. Just because of you. Just because of you, boy. Just because of you. I got the same old phrase. I got the same old tears. I tell the same old jokes. Give the same old grins. Now the jokes sound new. The laughter does too. Every day of my life is fresh and morning dew. Just because of you, just boy. Just because of you. Just because of you,
just because of you,
just because of you,
just because of you.
I go to the same old places, see the same old faces, look at the same old skies, see them all brand new. Just because of you,
just boy,
just because of you,
just because of you,
just because of you.